Hey everybody, welcome back to Pixel Junkies. On hey. This Wednesday, whenever you're watching this.
We're playing Prey.
Playing Prey.
I am,
Rory's back.
I forget how to play.
For
almost shot an town episode. There.
Did we sync the mics?
Yeah, we synced everything. Right. We just synced the mics.
Okay.
Synced it. Everything's under control. I forget what to do. How's everyone doing this week?
Good, right. Very good.
That's too bad.
Oh, man, Aaron. Some serious disappointment.
Starting off with a bit of
some of that bait and switch humor. You're doing it. You're doing well. Well, that's too bad.
Do I go through this door? Is this where I go?
I don't know. Did you kill them jisms? Them ghosts?
You can barely see. I can see just fine.
I can barely see. Well, turn up your brightness, Tommy. You asshole. Jesus.
Yeah.
This is some sharp edges on those doors that them aliens got. When they open up, there's like this big sharp piece.
Also
those vag doors. Imagine if doors were like massive vaginas, and they were like slow, sticky and slimy. Every time you went through a door, it was just that. I mean, these guys got it. These guys got vag doors.
That's a good point.
I hate these guys. They're the only people I'm fighting now.
Like, oh, hey, man, like. Like you're being born like Neo in the Matrix every time you go through a door, with a big metal condom on your penis.
I haven't seen the first Matrix movie in a long time. I've seen it like 1,000 times, but I haven't seen it in a while.
Well, did you have a metal condom on your dick?
No. What? How is it? What?
When Neo is birthed out of that tube or whatnot. When he
Right. Yeah.
Yeah. Just if you pause it at the right frame, you can see this big black metal thing on his knob.
Definitely a condom.
Well, one of them cod pieces, you know, like the dancer belt or whatever. So it wasn't a dancer belt, it was just straight up a metal thing on his dick.
Yeah. Well, they were, like, taking energy from him, so that kind
of
makes sense.
They're sucking energy out of his knob.
Yeah, basically. Yeah. Probably, actually.
Probably like a dick shield. It's like you couldn't get castrated into the thing.
Mm.
See, look at that. Imagine if that was a door that you had to go through.
Yeah, it'd be pretty unusual.
You'd think twice about going through doors.
Yeah.
Like, I gotta use a bathroom. Do I really need to use the bathroom?
You think it would, like, make us more efficient in life? Because we wouldn't be trying to go through doors all the time. We'd be like,
yeah.
Maybe I shouldn't use the washroom at work. Maybe I'm just gonna hold it for 10 hours while I work.
Yeah. Also, I think people would fuck them, too.
It's a good point, actually. No, they definitely would. They definitely would.
Oh,
you see a knob
dear.
Coming through the other side of the door. Stop fucking the door, John. Beautiful noise. Man, that cop don't give a fuck.
I think that's an ambulance.
Yeah, whatever.
I don't know why that happened, because my body's not there with me. That cop really doesn't care, though.
He's been immortalized now. If that guy was having, like, a heart attack or something, that's immortalized now.
What?
They'll be on YouTube forever.
Yeah.
That guy's trip to the hospital.
Yeah.
Which is really what you
he'll
want.
Like, he'll be watching YouTube in, like, a year and be like, hey, man, that was fucking... That was me in the back of that ambulance. I don't know how he would know that, but...
He'd probably know just by the... I don't know, actually, he probably wouldn't know.
The exact
well, if he's watching our videos, pitch. He probably knows us, so it's probably Jordan.
It was Jordan. Yeah, that's what he meant by Jordan was going downtown. He's going downtown in the back of an ambulance.
Yeah, exactly, yeah.
He ate too many of them fucking peasies. He got his heart all clogged up. Well, if you don't know what peasies are, Jordan loves eating these... They're like pea chips, literally peas, like a pea pod, but in like cheesy shape.
Yeah.
And actually, I think it's just Canadians that call them cheesies because some of my American friends don't know what a cheesy is.
No, it's
Cheetos.
A Canadian thing. Yeah, Cheetos. Yeah.
Cheetos. But
well, they're
green.
Not Cheetos, but they are.
They look
right?
like
they're
Cheetos.
Not Cheeto brand, but yeah.
Yeah, they look like Cheetos, but they're green and taste like peas.
So
we call them peasies.
Do they have cheesies in America? Like Cheetos are like harder. They're not like Hawkins cheesies, but they're like harder, right?
They're not
But yeah, they are.
Cheetos? No, they're not.
They're harder than cheesies.
Are they?
Yeah.
You're
cheesies
talking about
like
the puff
styrofoam
ones.
With cheese on.
Yeah, but that there's two different. There's
yeah,
two
but those
kinds
aren't
cheesies.
Cheetos. There's no Cheetos that are like that. Those
they
are
they
cheesies.
Are.
Like the
you
styrofoam ones are cheesies.
You can get puffed.
Oh,
well,
I just
killed
myself because I'm
you?
Yeah.
Okay, because I was going to say, if we are the only people who have a name for cheesies, are we the only people who have cheesies? Like, does America have cheesies, or do they just have Cheetos?
Yeah, see, look, Cheetos, they're puffed.
Oh, you're right. Okay, yeah. When we say cheesies, we mean puffed Cheetos. Like, Cheetos, like hard Cheetos, aren't Cheezies.
Yeah, they look. It looks like feces, but it's orange.
Yeah.
And tiny.
Add another one to the Hawkins Cheezy reference counter.
Man, this guy loves his Cheezies. Look at that.
Oh my god, that is the most disturbing thing I've ever seen in my life.
Look at this, Adam.
Oh god! Throw that up on the screen.
I'll have to save this image. I have to save this image.
So scary.
How do I save it?
Oh man, hey look!
Oh man, a slot machine. Let's play some video, whatever you call it, video lettuce and tomato.
Video slots.
Aren't they video lettuce and tomato?
Yeah, VLTs, that's right, yeah. What does that actually stand for?
What the fuck is this? Some guy photoshopped his face.
Are you like Cheezy's fan art or something? Like Cheezy's on DeviantArt?
Some guy photoshopped his face onto a Cheezy. It looks so stupid. Well, I don't know if it's his face or not.
I'm going to readjust Jesus his microphone stand because Adam has this like balanced and unusual
way. That guy
way.
Fucking ate knobs. What is going on here?
I don't know.
He was like inside of an asteroid and hit the ground and exploded.
No, the asteroid hit him.
Oh. I thought he was inside of it and he just like... Can you give yourself, like, a spirit blowy?
Probably.
Would you feel it?
That's a really, like, high-level philosophical question.
Or would you feel it?
Oh, you fucking clod-eared bent. Oh.
Adam tree walks falls straight off the edge.
If a tree falls in the woods, do you feel yourself give you a blowy? Yeah. Stupid ass.
What started that like tree falling in the woods question? Like who's
people on drugs probably.
Yeah, probably actually.
I mean, well, I guess it's not so much does it make a sound, is it? It's like it's defining is a sound wave or is a sound wave the interpretation of sound waves? So it's like no, it doesn't make
sound
a sound.
Sound waves superior, construct the cons inferior.
Yeah. No, it's not making a sound in the sense that no one's hearing it. But yes, it's
Adam,
making
what is
physical
from?
Sound waves.
It's from the Transformers movie, Rory.
Oh, that's good.
With Shia LaBeouf.
Which one?
The fourth one, the one you love so much?
No, the good one, the animated one.
With whatever
his
name is.
Oh, the animated one, okay.
What's his name? Tiggy Henderson, what's his name?
Are you talking about TJ Miller?
There you go, TJ Miller.
Tiggy Henderson.
I don't know.
Tiggy.
I don't know, that's a cool name.
Yeah, Tiggy's a great name.
It is. It's like
I like Tigger.
Tigger's brother or whatever.
I met a guy named Tigger.
Me too.
Is that on his birth certificate?
Oh,
it's like, my name's Tigger, here, look. And he handed
Forward.
You his birth certificate?
No, it's just a guy named Tigger. He was like, I don't know, man, it's a long story.
Is it?
Yeah, it kind of is, actually.
Is that what he's saying?
Oh,
like,
oh
why are your
man,
name's
it's
Tigger?
The brother.
That's a long story.
Maybe that's what was his nickname. That's what everyone called him. I always assumed it was his
parents
actual name.
Parents were on drugs, so Tigger.
A lot of people got weird names, right?
Yeah.
I mean, yeah, a few.
I liked Drigger from Beyblades when that was a
Who
thing.
Was Drigger?
It was like a dragon or something.
Yeah, it was one of the Beyblades.
It was like a
Do you
dragon
that, show,
that
Adam?
Lived in a Beyblade or something. Nonsense.
Yeah, but I don't remember a character named Drigger.
Really? Well, he was like the main Beyblade.
I
mean,
there was like some dude named Ray, I think his name was. I feel like.
Yeah, but he had a...
And he had a Beyblade named Drigger.
Yeah, he did.
Was it the tiger?
I don't know. I'm just learning to look it up now.
Yeah.
I really haven't... I didn't even watch a lot of it when it was on.
I watched a lot of it when it was on.
Drigger. I remember the turtle was called Drasile.
Yeah, look, Drigger. I just searched
Drigger.
And it's the first thing.
He's the gray one.
Is he the tiger?
Oh yeah, no, it is a tiger.
Cause there's...
Yeah, he's the tiger.
It's also...
I thought that said shit-eating
station. It's also on Urban Dictionary as one who has sexual intercourse with an ungodly amount of women. So, I don't even know.
Not a bad thing to name a Beyblade after, I guess.
Dead Trigger getting mad puss. Yeah. Yeah, it was some saber-tooth tiger with gold shit on him.
What was the bird called? Because the dragon was called Dragoon and the turtle was called Drasile, wasn't it?
I don't know. Oh, we got some Rule 34 going on here.
Don't worry, I'll go in the spirit mode. That'll save me.
Trigger Rule 34.
What?
Yeah. And we'll get off that.
Yeah, probably a good call. Was it like the tiger or the Beyblade?
No, it was the tiger having sex with some other thing. Some orange thing. Probably cheesy.
People are weird.
Oh, yeah, Hawk is cheesy.
Man, that cheesy, that Drigger cheesy getting some mad tiger puss. You know it.
Man. Yeah, people are unusual, but that's one of the great things about people. Like, not Rule 34 Drigger. That
they're
but,
all
I mean,
about
in general,
like the turbo spin tops with sex. Turbo spin top sex. I like that they used to put flint on them. Like, you had the metal rings, but they had like a flint coating or something. So whenever your Beyblades would hit, they would spark, and it was like, man, shit's happening now.
Yeah, I agree.
But then they got rid of that, I think. Like, after, like, Gen 1 Beyblades, they made them all out of, like, turbo shitty plastic.
Gen 1.
Had a bunch of Gen.
Yeah, there was, like, some sort of generational thing going
on. It was cool in the sense that it was one of those anime, like, crazes that you could actually do the thing they did in the show.
Exactly.
Except not really.
Well, obviously not really, Adam, but it was close enough.
Like, you can't have a Pikachu. You can have a stuffed toy of one or whatever, or a plastic Pikachu.
But you can actually do the activity. Yeah. Although, no, to be honest, you can do the activity of Pokemon in the Pokemon game, insofar as...
In the game, but in this it was like, you could literally customize your spin top.
Yeah, that's true, yeah.
Like,
but it never worked. Like, in the show, they'd be like, Dragoon, use the ultimate spin attack, and he'd jump up in the air and do a backflip.
Yeah, I know what you're saying. It was stupid in concept that these, like, dreidels would attack each other with, like, cataclysmic force.
Dreidel.
But, Jesus Christ. Holy fuck. They'll never find all of him. there he is there. I thought that was a part of his body that just fucking exploded. But I like the idea of, being able to take them apart and build custom ones.
Yeah,
that
I agree.
Cool. Especially all the ones that they had at the X store that was here. Like, they had all these, like, I guess they were, like, actual... That's called the It store now.
Who knows what it's called now? I'm pretty sure it's called something else now. Oh. It's gone through, like, 1,000 different names.
Yeah, well, it was like this...
It's this random store we have here that sells random things.
Yeah, it's like...
There's
can
no
buy
organization to
t-shirts
it.
T-shirts and toys and, like, dildos.
Yeah, it's like...
And bongs.
It's literally just everything.
Yeah, it's kind of like a semi-sex store, also a Toys R Us store.
Yeah, it's really... It's a strange place, but it's kind of chill, so... Yeah. It's cool.
It's all right, store.
It's cool that we have it in a mall.
But they had all like these... Yeah,
the mall
it's like
here
right
is just
at the
random.
Front of the mall.
Like our mall, like people like maybe like, I don't know, our viewers, like maybe you live in Edmonton and you're picturing like the West Edmonton Mall or something. No,
yeah, it's not
our
big.
Mall is just like lunacy. We have two malls. Well, technically we have three.
You go in the main entrance of this mall and it's a food court with like 15 restaurants and then the X store.
Yeah.
Like right near the entrance.
Yeah.
So like dildos hanging out in their window, just like, all right, there you go.
Hey, Aaron,
our city is so strange.
Oh man, look at the potatoes back.
We have two malls in like our city or in like neighboring municipalities that are just like they're dead. Like we have two dead malls. We have one mall that people still go to, and we have two like
almost
entirely dead.
What's the other one?
Yeah, what's the third mall?
The Sobey Square Mall.
That's not a mall anymore.
That's not even a mall.
The Village Mall is still a mall.
It's not a mall anymore because it's gone. But yeah, like it tried. It really tried for a long time after it was dead.
Is Sobey Square still there?
Yeah, it's still there.
So it's just this really. So all right. So back in the day, it used to be like a kind of a strip mall plaza with a supermarket. Yeah.
And it was busy, man, back when I was a kid, back when you and I were kids.
That used
to
be the theater to go to.
Yeah,
didn't
it was.
Have Cineplex back then. But now you're saying it's literally just a tiny ass theater.
Basically.
That's behind some like law firm building. Fucking hell.
Yeah, it's like behind it's like behind like a healthcare place and like an insurance place. And I think the space for the Sobeys, I don't even know what that is anymore. Like what the Sobeys was.
Well, it's Sobeys, then it was Price Choppers, and then I don't know what it is now. I don't think it's anything now.
I have no idea. It's like a ghost town now.
Yeah.
Like even the theater closed down the ticket booth. Like you get the tickets now at the same place you get your food. The ticket booth is just empty.
Why are they
just
even...
a small town now?
I saw, what was the last movie you saw there?
What was the last movie I saw there? Yeah. Neighbors 2. We went to see Neighbors 2 there.
This wasn't that long ago, though.
That was like a few months ago. which was a good movie, by the way.
The last movie I saw.
Shout out to Neighbors 2, Zac Efron.
I saw War of the Worlds there. That was the last one I saw.
Oh, really? No, yeah. I've seen like movies there. Like I've seen like maybe 5 movies there over the past 2 years.
We saw it so late that that was the only theater it was available at.
Oh, really?
Yeah, so it was out of Empire Theaters at the time. There's a lot of local talk for the audience, but we had Sobey Square, which was a privately run, small-ass, 40-seat theater.
Whoa!
Then we got Empire Theaters, which was an actual theater, yeah, albeit small. Now we have Cineplex, which is like a fucking mogul of a thing, and yeah, with IMAX. Exactly, yeah.
It's also awful.
The Village Mall does not have a theater. The Village Mall is
Empire Theater's
giant nightmare.
It had free refills.
Is it Sports Check?
There's
a Google review for Sobey Square. A lot of offices and a few stores. The old theater is here where you can see cheap movie.
Somebody who... cheap movie. Yeah, no, the guy who works there posted that.
Yeah.
Please...
Oh, it's on. It also has an entry on deadmalls.com. Okay, that's terrific.
Yeah, no, this is one of those like hick small town theaters where they have one movie that was from like 8 months ago playing, and they have like one showtime a week. That's what Sobey Square is.
Oh, like, oh.
It had a Byway, a Susie Shear, Eclipse, and a Bugger too.
Well, just check and see what movies are playing there.
Oh yeah, it's like old movies, basically. It's
like, oh, you didn't see Dark Knight when it came out in 2009 or whatever?
Yeah, it's still playing. It's Sobey Square.
Available now. Sobey Square.
Here's just so you have an idea of like how far this mall went. In 2005, the middle of the mall was being converted to a Teletech Canada call center.
Also, isn't it Sobeys?
What?
Isn't it Sobeys? Because it used to be in the supermarket called, yeah, Sobeys. So it should be Sobey's Square.
Yeah,
not,
yeah.
Not Sobey Square. not the energy drink. People are gonna be like, oh, the energy drink has a theater? No. It doesn't.
Oh, yeah, I forgot about the Torbay Road Mall. This is also mentioned on Dead Malls.
Fucking hell. Oh, my God, Adam.
The Torbay Road Mall is another practically dead mall we have here, which is like a tiny little plaza thing. And it's like, I can't even explain the Torbay Road Mall. It's ridiculous.
I've never been there.
Really? What? Oh,
what the fuck?
You've never been there?
Torbay Road Mall?
Yeah.
What is that?
It's like... It's hard to explain.
What's in it? Torbay?
China House?
I don't know what
the
that
Chinese,
is.
It's a Chinese restaurant in the city. We're not in the city right now, for those wondering. We're not. That's why I refer to in the city, because we are not currently in the city.
One of the auto-completes.
We're outside the city.
So much local talk for all of these people who probably...
Yeah, I know. Yeah.
Torbay Road Mall. So what's next to it?
I don't know, man. Tim Hortons? There's a Tim Hortons. There's a Shoppers parking lot. There's a Shoppers literally in the parking lot.
Show me fucking...
Street View. Get some Street View going.
Satellite is what I want. Now, let me try and see here. So it's next to a school or a church or some nonsense.
Yeah, it is. Or some nonsense.
Well, I just said Holy Mary Queen of something. Easy Home. Pizza Express. Oh, okay.
Thomas used to work at Pizza
Express.
That's
a mall.
Yeah.
Oh, I've been there.
Yeah.
That is okay. Now I know what it is. I've been there. I was there once. It is literally the worst.
No, Sobey's is worse.
No, Sobey's.
You can get something to eat in
Sobey Square is light years beyond. Yes, you can get something to eat at this place too. The problem is it takes like 47 hours and it's made by like 3 of the most unclean humans on the planet. It's like, we went there once because I had to go to a meeting after class
Pizza
once.
Express?
I guess it was Pizza Express.
It's the little pizza shop they got.
That's like a rectangle shape. Fucking. There we go. It's like a really long oblong shape where it's like, their restaurant is in a hallway is what it looks like.
Yeah.
So we went there once because I had a meeting after class in college.
Yeah.
And it was like 7 or 8 o'clock at night, and it was the closest place nearby to get something to eat. So I went there to get something to eat, and while I was waiting for my food to get made, because apparently it took him like a half an hour to make a fucking calzone or whatever. It's like a fucking pizza pocket, man. When you have this shit, like, what was the first customer that I had in a week? They didn't have anything pre-made. Anyway, so then I was walking around there, and there was like a thrift shop, and I'm pretty sure they sold used underwear. There was like underwear bin. Yeah. It's like, I don't want secondhand underwear. I don't care how many times you wash that. Someone's butthole was on that fabric, and now it's in a store where friggin' anybody can touch it. It's friggin' Christ almighty. Not to mention, like, if you shat yourself or pissed yourself or got a little bit of specimen in there, you know. Who knows what's been in them drawers?
Yeah, disgusting. It's an unusual mall, but they've got a kind of rockin' Chinese place there, so it makes up for it.
I didn't see that.
I only go there for the Chinese place.
It's also this mall as well. Is the tiniest mall you can think of. It's an L shape.
It really that is. Killed me. It's like a broken L. And there's also a Shoppers. It's a drugstore. It's a local drugstore. I don't know how big a chain Shoppers is, but there's a Shoppers in the parking lot.
Yeah, Shoppers is almost as big as the mall.
It's almost as big as the mall, and it's in the damn parking lot, like in the middle of the parking lot. It's like, what is this doing here?
You could clearly see through the whole mall if they didn't have a right angle in it for no reason.
Yeah.
Like, oh, let's put a corner here so people think it's bigger.
The mall really lost a lot of foot traffic when the bank moved out.
For those who don't get it, Aaron, you're not from town, are you? Originally?
No, I'm from right here. Well, yeah, I mean, I was born in town.
So me and Adam are from town.
R.I.P. Grace Hospital.
And it's like, it's hard. Yeah, I was born there too, actually. It's like hard to explain, like, how weird our, like, the town we come from is.
Yeah.
Like, it's like, everything is just so stupid.
Yeah. Zero, like, negative thought went into building all this crap.
Yeah, everything that we have, the roads, like, everything is stupid. Like, the roads are just, like, our downtown area, like, every place has a downtown. Listening, you're from, like, Toronto or something, you know, like, downtown, right?
Yeah, well, but,
like,
all those buildings downtown were built before roads were invented.
They were all built before roads were invented. And when they put the roads in, they're all one way. And they're all going in, like, a different direction. We have, a five or a six-way intersection. And in the middle of the intersection is a church.
Not to mention
in the middle of the damn intersection.
Two of the potential
just
directions you can go.
Look up downtown St. John's on Google Street.
Gower Street United Church for the church that appears smack in the middle.
And two of the directions that you can go next to the Sheridan are fucking blind hills.
Yeah, exactly.
Like, if you're coming up into a six-way intersection, you can't see anything.
You ever hear those, like, nonsense stories about people walking to school uphill both ways? Well, those stories all come from downtown St. John's, and they're all true.
Yeah, where people live on vertical hills. Like,
yeah, exactly.
San Francisco got not in downtown.
The can't park downtown in the winter because your car is going to slide down the road. Like, seriously, like, driving up those roads in the winter is actually the scariest thing you can do.
Not to mention the parking lot that's on Victoria Street or whatever. It's like a 60-degree incline, and there's a parking lot on it.
Yeah, there are these, like, piece of shit downtown parking lots.
It feels like when you get out of your car, it's just going to tip over and roll down the hill. It's so terrible.
It's so bad. I'm creating more work for Aaron. Just, like, throw up some pictures of this crappy town that me and Adam live in. Like, this is, like, the worst.
Yeah, it's pretty awful. Anyway, we should clue it up. What did you accomplish this episode? Adam, me and Rory were romancing.
Nothing.
Waxing
St.
John's.
Oh, no.
Did you throw yourself into an orbit? Just see if you can do that. Just, like, sprinting in turbo hops.
There's no sprint.
Oh.
This is before Sprint.
Oh, yes, before Sprint was invented.
It really was, though. Like, Sprint only became a thing, like, I can't remember that I played. What was the first game you guys played that have Sprint, like, first-person game?
Probably Call of Duty.
Yeah?
Did the first Call of Duty have Sprint?
No, the first Call of Duty did not have Sprint, I'm pretty sure.
I don't know.
Like, what, the third Call of Duty had Sprint, though, right?
Yes. I think that might have been a selling feature for it, which is hilarious, because that game sucked. I really can't remember. It was probably some fucking DOS game. I don't know.
DOS Sprint.
I'm sure some DOS game had a sprint function. Would it not have?
Yeah, you're probably right. It's probably some old game that no one knows. Like,
yeah.
It's probably like Sprint only came in the mainstream with certain games, though, for sure.
I didn't really play a whole lot of, like, running around games as a kid. A lot of it was, like, vehicle-based games.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, I mean, like,
I play mostly running around games, like Unreal Tournament.
Well, actually, I'll tell you probably about my first game that had Sprint in it was. Would have been FIFA 98.
Oh, really?
Yeah, because that game had a sprint function.
Oh, okay, yeah.
Where you could, like, oh, it was, like, walk
in. Oh, yeah, yeah. No, yeah, and, like Madden, like, 98 or whatever, also had, like, sprint, I guess you could say, yeah. I think.
We should do a special in FIFA 98. That was a good game.
That's a good idea.
Next World Cup.
All right, we're cluing it up. We'll see you guys later.
Bye.
Good night, everybody.